Hey, 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 welcome back to RM Podcast FL. This is your favorite podcaster, Romina, and I want to thank you guys for tuning in and investing your time towards our podcast. So, happy Thursday, first and foremost, and for those who are in Florida, I hope you did not get affected by Hurricane Dorian. I had to leave Jacksonville, unfortunately, because the weather was supposed to be really bad. But as of right now, I hear there's no damages in Florida, in Jacksonville, so we're good. But without losing any time, let's go ahead and dive into today's episode, or how I like to call the Thursday's episode, educational episodes. So today's topic is Rolls-Royce collecting garbage. Now, this is an interesting one, you guys, so let's dive right in. Rolls-Royce is a British luxury car brand established in 1904 by the partnership of Charles Rolls and Henry Royce. Currently, the lowest MSRP of a Rolls-Royce is right about $311,000. Now, Indian King Jai Singh, Maharaja of Alwar, was once interested in a Rolls-Royce car. Back in 1920, when the king visited London, he was walking in the city and just wandering around, dressed up very casual. He looked just like another citizen. During this walk, he came across the Rolls-Royce showroom in the Bond Street and decided to take a look inside and asked one of the salesmen about the specification of the car and the price. The showroom salesman saw an Indian man, dressed up like an average guy, and told him to get out of the showroom as there's no way in the world he could afford the car, and he was making the showroom look bad. He completely humiliated the king without having a clue what he was doing. So King left. He was very furious, and when he went back to his hotel, he called his servants and commanded them to call Rolls-Royce and schedule a meeting. So the servants called the dealership and advised them that the king of Alwar City is interested in a few cars. But this time around, when the king showed up at the dealership, there was a red carpet rolled out in the showroom, and all salesmen were lined up to honor the king. After a couple of hours, the king decided to purchase 6 cars. And he went ahead and paid for all 6 of them in cash at the time of the purchase. And he also paid to deliver the cars in India. After the cars were delivered to India, the king ordered the cars to be used for transportation and for collecting garbage in the city. Now imagine, the world's number one car was being used to collect garbage. The reputation of the company was ruined all over the world. And if you were to be respected and honored for having a Rolls-Royce before, now you're being humiliated because you were driving a car that was being used to collect garbage. And this was a big insult to the company. Their sales dropped drastically and they were having a hard time. After a while, Rolls-Royce sent a telegram to the Indian King apologizing for the mistake, for what had happened back in London, and offering him 6 more cars for free. The king very happily accepted the cars, as well as accepted the apology. Once the cars were delivered, he stopped using the luxury cars for garbage collections. Now I want to ask you guys, how many times have you judged somebody just by the way they look? I've done it in the past too. I'm not gonna lie and say I have not. But the more I grew up and the more people I connect with, I understand that judging will not get you anywhere. How are you supposed to know the person you come across might be your future partner, your new best friend, or even your business partner if you judge them? The only way to find out is by being genuine and getting to know the person before you put labels on someone and start judging them. It's very easy to judge somebody, but not very easy to know someone. So sometimes people like to take shortcuts, but that does take a longer time. So I hope this story is a great example of why you should not be judging people, and I hope everybody learns slightly a little lesson from it. And don't forget, every Thursdays, we do have episodes on iTunes, Spotify, Stitchers Radio, YouTube, Podbean, Google Play, and www.rmpodcastfl.com.